Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what is a reference electrode and what were the types of the reference electrode. So now we are going to talk about the primary reference electrode, that is a saturated standard hydrogen electrode. So let us see what is it. So this is the schematic diagram of a standard hydrogen electrode, in which you can see that it consists of a glass jacket which covers a copper wire filled with a mercury, and that copper wire is passed through a gas, is passed through a glass, and it is connected through a platinum foil with the help of a platinum wire. And this whole apparatus is been kept in a 1 molar HCl solution, and when a pure gas of H2 at 1 atmosphere is passed through this tube, then this H2 gas bubbles out, and this H2 gas that bubbles out plays a very important role in the conduction of the electricity, or we could say in the calculation of the other electrode, the cell potential of the other electrode. So by the help of this, this is a diagram in which the copper wire is used for external connection of the circuit, while this platinum foil is an inert electrode. It acts as an inert electrode on which the H2 gas gets deposited, or H2 gas gets bubbled up on this platinum foil, while this mercury is there for the connection between this copper and this platinum wire, while the solution that is being used in this standard hydrogen electrode is 1 molar HCl solution. So this has a potential of 0 volt. So this means that by connecting this electrode with other electrode, we could easily find out what would be the potential of the other electrode. And since this is an electrode, so this can be acting as an anode as well as it can be acted as a cathode. So let us see what are the applications of this kind of standard hydrogen electrode. So as we know that as the potential of the SHE in this case means a standard hydrogen electrode is 0 volt, therefore it is used to measure the cell potential, and hence determination of the standard potential of other electrode is also very easy in this case. How? See, if I talk about a cell diagram in which you can see that the magnesium, which is connected at anode because it is connected, because it is represented at the extreme left of the cell formula, so therefore magnesium is acting as an anode, while this platinum and this H2, this thing is nothing but the standard hydrogen electrodes cell formula, which consists of 1 molar of HCl, and this Mg2+ has also a concentration of 1 molar. So in this case, I could calculate what would be the cell potential, or what could be the electrode potential of this magnesium. So the cell potential of this cell was found to be 2.37 volt. So if I apply the formula that E naught cell is equals to E naught of SHE minus E naught of Mg, then since I know that the cell potential, or that the electrode potential of the SHE is found to be 0.0 volt, while that of the E cell that has been calculated or that has been measured was found to be 2.37 volt, and I have to calculate the electrode potential of magnesium. So it is very easy, then I could get that E naught of magnesium is equal to minus 2.37 volt. So this is how we could calculate the electrode potential of the other electrode when it is connected to SHE. It's a very simple device. So if you connect any electrode with SHE, then the overall cell potential that you observe will be the cell, will be the electrode potential of the other electrode that you are using, because the electrode potential of SHE is 0 volt. So it depends on what it has been used. It is used as an anode or it is used as a cathode. You could determine it very easily with the help of this formula also. So now let us see what are the advantages of SHE that we are using in this cell diagram or in this experiment. The advantages of SHE is it is easy to determine the electrode potential of the other electrode. By connecting it with other electrode, we could easily determine what would be the electrode potential of the other electrode when it is connected to SHE. But there are also few disadvantages of the saturated standard hydrogen electrode, which is pure and dry H2 gas is difficult to maintain. So if pure dry H2 gas is not being maintained, then the cell potential would not be zero and it would differentiate. So it plays a very important role that we should use such gas which is pure and dry. And in this case, we are using H2 gas. The next thing is pressure of H2 gas at exactly 1 atmosphere is also difficult to maintain. So these are the difficulties that are being faced during this determination of the cell potential when this is connected to the other electrode. And the most disadvantage part is the bubbling of H2 gas results in the evaporation of water. This evaporation of water could change the concentration of the solution in which it is kept. Because the concentration of the solution that is kept in this case is 1 molar. So if the water gets evaporated, the concentration would change. And because of the concentration would change, the cell potential will also have an adverse effect on it. And we couldn't get a proper voltage, or we couldn't get a proper EMF of the other electrode or the overall cell. So these were the few disadvantages regarding SHE. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to an idea that SHE plays a very important role in determination of the cell potential as well as the electrode potential of a particular electrode. So share this video with your friends and yes, don't forget to subscribe to eGeta channel. Thank you so much.